TickTick's a to-do list application that works in sync across all your devices. That's your computer, an iPhone or Android, a tablet, Apple Watch, and even on a web page. In this video, I'll show you how to add your thoughts and ideas to your phone or tablet, and this is following my GAP theory. Click the I above to review that theory. My name's Bruce, and if you already know me, well, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell, and it helps me make more videos for you. In the previous tutorials, I showed you how to set up TickTick with folders and lists so you can gather your items that are needing to be done as you think of them. Click the I above to review that tutorial. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you on the iPhone and the iPad. Text can be copied and pasted into your inbox. You press the plus sign and either type or paste the copied text. You could even use dictation, and I'll show you a version of that in a minute. And what you've just looked at works on an iPad and an iPhone. I'm showing you on the iPad here, along with the computer version of TickTick. And you can see as I add a new idea to the iPad, it almost instantly syncs with the computer. And here it's doing the same thing with the iPhone. And you can set up really quick ways of adding to TickTick. There's a cool feature on the iPhone that lets you add an idea with dictation, almost hands-free, even on a lock screen. You double tap on the back of the phone, and a shortcut appears allowing you to dictate. That's converted to text, and it's added to the inbox with no further action from you. This is really cool. Let me show you. I'll first double tap the back of the iPhone. Now I can dictate, and the text has been added to the inbox. Here it is in the inbox. And let me show you how to set this up as a shortcut on the iPhone. Select the Shortcuts app, click All Shortcuts. Click the plus at the top right. Now add action, and search for dictate. Select Dictate Text, and you may need to enable dictation in settings if you've not used this before. You'll be taken to settings anyway to do it. Select Show More. Select your language. Choose Stop Listening after pause. There are other options, but I find after pause works well in this situation. Click the search field again and select Apps. Find TickTick, and they're in alphabetical order. Select Add Tasks. Click on the word Tasks, and select Dictated Text. Select Day for the date. Make sure Inbox is selected, and turn on Edit in App. Select Next. Now give the shortcut a name. You can also use Siri to run this shortcut as well as the double tap. Select an icon and the color. Click Done. And it's now showing in your shortcuts. Hold the shortcut until this screen appears and select Share. Add to Home Screen. Press Add at the top right. And now you'll see it on your home screen. Try it from here to see if it's working okay. Now you need to add the shortcut to the double tap feature. Go to Settings on the iPhone, select Accessibility, select Touch, scroll down all the way to Back Tap, select Double Tap and then the shortcut. And now try it out and view the entry in TickTick. You can add something similar on the iPad. And what you get is a tap location that stays on for any screen no matter what app is active. And to create this, set up the shortcut as I showed you before. Select Settings and Accessibility. Turn on Assistive Touch. Select Single Tap. And select the shortcut Dictate. Exit the settings and that touch button shows all the time. And you can move the button to any location that you prefer. The next video will cover the use of TickTick while you're on a web page in Chrome, Safari, or Firefox. And if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell to be notified of those further tutorials in the series.